stay coordinated. We're both in blue, and I hate filming.
You can't see the shit.
I can't see shit. It drives me up. All right, so this week we're working on what happens when I want to pass the half bar. Last week we worked on coming up, dogfighting, doing some unnecessary stuff for people. Today we're going to work on countering that. So first thing we're going to do, get a good wide base, send it to our active toes, right? I'm going to bring that elbow to the inside of the knee. I'm going to rotate that knee out, blocking his bicep, or grabbing a good collar grip, depending on what you're wanting to do. Once I'm here, I'm going to pop my knee up, over, stepping on top of Austin's leg here in that staple position, posting up in good position here. Once we're here, guys, very simply, we're just going to baseball slide our way through. Big detail that a couple of you guys kept missing. A lot of you guys were just trying to grab the head and baseball slide through. That'll give up your back. So when I'm here, I dig for the underhook. Scoop his tricep, baseball slide through. A couple positioning things for scissor side. My knee should be next to his head. My foot should be posted level with my hip. And when I'm here, I'm floating my hip that little bit. Can you see the discomfort in Austin's face here?
Always.
Because when I'm floating that hip, I one, have the mobility to do any of the movements I need to do. But two, puts all my weight on his lower ribs, which I'm just an asshole. That's appreciated. So when I'm here, I'm just picking that hip up a little bit. My foot can still be touching. My knee and hip are off the mat here. Nice little bit of space here. Put that weight on him, all 190 pounds of sexy right now. JJ's not over here. I can say it by my name. I'm fat right now. So, I'm right here. I clear that elbow. Boom. And I block that so that he can't control the distance anymore. Because what he's using this knee for is to control me from pressuring on top of him. So by clearing that, boom. Now he can't control the distance and I can come up. Once I'm here, I prefer a good collar grip just because I also like the baseball bat choke from here. But I'm going to set a good little collar grip, dig for that underhook, and I'm going to stretch him out. Because now I got his hips pointing this way, and I'm driving his shoulders that way. So now I got him good and twisted up. Boom, sit out. Get into scissor side control. Start doing all the fun stuff we've learned from here. Questions on this one? Review from Tuesday. Most of you guys were here. Here. Boom. I clear. Come up. Step. Dig. Slide. Finish the center side. Go, let me hit my leg. Fun. Questions, comments, concerns? Like I said, review from Tuesday, but polish up a couple details. Things are going well. I get in this half guard, I clear, I come up, I get here, but Austin doesn't suck at jiu-jitsu, so he's gonna trap my ankle. He's gonna start closing that down and really just trying to hold on. Not particularly trying to go anywhere with it, he's just trying to hold on to my ankle. So that way I can't just kick through. So all we're gonna do, dig for my underhook, dig for that tricep, but now I'm gonna post my head. Two options. There's the friendly and less friendly option. The friendly option, I can post my forehead, kick out, and slide. Friendly option. Remember, we don't set up jiu-jitsu to make new friends. We want new enemies. I'm gonna put my head right between his ear and his jawline. Let him know you love him. Kick that leg out, slide through. Crazy that we're at, we just feel trapped in that ankle, working through. Here, I clear, try to come up, he traps that ankle down. A lot of guys are going to trap that ankle and try to start sitting up into you guys. That's where digging for this underhook is going to become crucial.
Once we're there, we're going to be less friendly.
More friendly. Stick out, come here. What if his collar's really loose? And I don't feel like I can get just a good grip here, so I want to tuck it into his arm. I do like that grip quite a bit, or use this grip quite a bit, I'm here and I go to slide through, a lot of guys will bring their arm up and try to frame my face here. I like having this under the armpit, Rick, because I can block it. So if you want to play with having that little underarm grip, it's
nice.
Yeah,
somebody said really wide.
So Austin locks down for all of his heart's desire, right? Because I'm gonna put my head through his jawline, he doesn't get to have a choice in the way. Because if I can put my head through his jawline and I still can't get my foot out, you're doing something. Because if I'm here, I put tripod in.
Austin still has a burning urge to hold on to my foot.
I need to make that choice that's coming in. Even someone like a Danielson get real squirrely and try to like super lock down the leg here. So Daniel's gonna like lock down, you know, 10 plenty bullshit guard his way into this, right? I don't care. Because if I'm here, you position and kick through. There should be no reason to hold on. Questions on that? If I can get his face facing away, ideal. If not, put it through there. Because I'm not always going to have the ideal world of, you know, I can dig and get his head facing away. In an ideal world, I want it to be in that way, but if not, I'm going to drive it down and head up.
This is like, if I'm here, it's not just going to go down, I'm also going to be driving it up.
Post this mid. So like he, you know, some guys will get that death grip here, you know, they'll really lock down onto it. At that point, if I can't really dig and get the pressure, that's when we're going to start.
Yeah.
Doing the back step with squirt.
I got to put that down. Sorry.
Then I got to lose the ground. Any other questions on that position? What? All right, I'm here with Austin. I do all the right things, but Austin traps my ankle. I never appreciate people trapping my ankle. But during for some people, I'm not going to go side control. I'm not holding Jeremy in side control anytime in this calendar. I'm not going to actively choose side control because I don't feel like he's controlled. But he's too long when he gets moving. It's set. So instead of trying to pass to the side, guys, all I'm going to do, I'm going to dig this underhook. And I'm going to post this wrist up as high as I can get it. Whether that's with a wrist grip, here, tricep, I don't care how you get the head. Hand up, get it up there. I am just going to generally post the rest here. I'm still going to post my head and chin, but instead of trying to baseball slide through, I'm going to post my hips up, driving my hips across. 9 times out of 10, you're going to get your foot out. Sometimes they're still going to have a trap, and you're going to be like, hey, that's really not appreciated. You scoot up. There you go. Or attack their neck and they stop worrying about their feet so much. But instead of driving across to sit out, you're just popping up and driving across. So I'm here, good things are happening. Oh, here, Austin traps the ankle. Or let's say I need big points for a tournament. You're generally going to get two or three. Two for passing, four for mount. Pretty good swing right at once, where sometimes you won't get side control points for a tournament. Questions on that? More time, any other questions? Here. gonna do, start attacking things. I like throwing them. Guys, you're gonna get here. Guys are gonna dig up for that underhook, and you're gonna lose this fight. That's fine. If you can't get back in, which is always option A, realize option A is dig back in. Option B, top hand is gonna come to the armpit. I'm going to backstep, posting my foot. Hand is gonna touch the top of his knee. I'm gonna dig through for head. Straighten my foot, push the legs away. Oh yeah, I'm still tight right now. So when I'm here, when I backstep, I'm coming right here. I'm sitting as close to him as I can. Because he's naturally going to drive up into me. So I actually let your foot go. Look. If he like really locks down on this leg, all you have to do, push the knees away, rip, rise up. Who'd have thought, man? It's almost like we do warm-up drills for a reason. It's a really odd thing where I teach you guys really practical motions as part of the warm-ups and then you use it later in life. Or it's just torturous because I'm mean like that. You decide for yourselves. Questions on that. White belts, I want you guys working on. Questions, comments, concerns. Blue belts. Because I've somehow created an army of dirty foot lockers. He digs up, he comes up. Don't care, fall back. Attack it. If you're in the heat, you attack the straight knee bar. If you are pajama free, I come in, drive my knee under his knee, scoop his knee in. Play to the rule set you like, back step and back step. That is a great detail. As I'm coming back here, I'm grabbing, cupping his knee to pull that in. Two things it does. One, unpacks his feet. A lot of people start crossing their feet. So if I pull that leg out, it unpacks it. Two, if you're trying to hit the heels, it opens his ankle up to you. So if I'm here, it'll naturally put the ankle right where you need it. Attack those knees as needed. So, if I'm coming for the knee bar here, I'm coming. And if I can pick that knee up and touch my hips, great. Unlikely, most people are going to have their feet packed tight enough that you're not going to be able to scoot for like that heel in. Work for that knee. Questions on that? White belts, just work on stepping back, get your feet out. Blue belts, spend for them feet. Just roll their foot lockers anyway. I'm not going to do my entire curriculum. I get here. I clear the knee out, and it's like, hey, I don't want to pass. I just want to take this back. I'm lazy. Instantly to his back. All we're gonna do, I'm gonna clear that leg out and I'm gonna widen my base out as wide as I can. As soon as I do that, I'm gonna keep his leg hooked, tuck my head and my inside arm in between my legs. Here. Hammer my heel up, look for his back. I do black belt magic away today. I thought Riley had like a really bizarre look on his face, like he's seen this. He was just like you tucked one hand in between, like for a roll. We have that. We should come up with a drill. Man, it'd be real helpful.
Put it on paper.
Put it on paper. Make it a part of Walmart drills every day.
It'd be really helpful.
Probably need help. Questions on this one, guys? Biggest thing is, guys, a couple of the details that you all sent tend to fuck up. A lot of you guys try to like roll that way for some reason. You're trying to forward roll in between your own legs. And the other thing is, most of you guys don't look for his back. So when I get here, I instantly have to start trying to find his back. A lot of you guys just roll and hope. It's not going to work. I have to find his back. I'm generally going to grab a hip grip, something. And as I'm coming up, I sit into my line. Once you're here, backpack drill. Uncivilized. Back attacks. Any questions, guys? No super detailed questions. I'm going to choke or anything. One more time. Questions, guys?